Hi, everyone. Off to such a great start. My name is Stella, and I am the University Programs Lead at the Clorox Company and Burt's Bees. And I'm super excited to be introducing this session to y'all today. I know you all must be excited as well. We have a pretty fun hour planned for you. As you can see, we have quite a few panelists from the Burt's Bees and VMS, which is our vitamin, minerals, and supplements brand, come talk to you about our co-op programs and our roles. So today what we'll be doing is doing a really quick introduction into both the Burt's and VMS brands. And then we're going to dive into a Q&A so we can talk a little bit more about what it's like to recruit for both of these brands and land a role here. And then we'll open it up for Q&A afterwards. So like Brandon mentioned, if you have any questions, feel free to type it into the Q&A chat and we'll be able to answer some of those or hopefully all of those afterwards. So with that, I am going to try to share my screen at the same time and introduce you to Eddie, who is going to kick us off with the intro.
Hey, how are y'all doing? Welcome. Glad y'all could all make it to the Way Up session. We'll start by chatting on kind of a little background, high level, on Burt's Bees and how it got started. So Burt's Bees, it started with a guy actually named Burt. For those that are unaware, Burt Chavitz and Roxanne Quimby created Burt's Bees early in the 1980s, specifically 1984. So next year will be our 40th year anniversary, which we're very excited about. But Burt was living in, as well as Roxanne, we're living in Maine. Burt happened to pick up Roxanne as a hitchhiker in his school bus converted to a pickup truck, and they hit it off. Burt was the local bee man, so he was the one with the abundance of wax, and Roxanne was the entrepreneur that had the vision. So unfortunately, after Burt's passing, his cabin that he lived in, which you can see behind him in his picture, also behind myself, Lakin, and Crystal, is actually the cabin that he lived in, was actually moved down from Maine down to Durham, North Carolina, which is where the headquarters is, right outside the building itself. The honey or the bees you'll see also in this slide are also actually at the front door of our headquarters as well. We have a live beehive that we'll keep with weather permitting. So you'll naturally see some bees out in the area as well. So I'll pass it over to Crystal to tell you a little bit more about our product kind of life.
Hello, everyone. I'm Crystal. This slide just kind of depicts our journey, right? It's our journey map from when they started, when Burt's and Roxanna started in 1984, just making candles and beeswax and honey, to like the evolution of all the products that we currently have today. And some milestones are, like, if you look at 2006, they kind of started launching into drug and grocery stores. So it was more, you know, not just selling them outside of his van or everything, and they just had a wider distribution. And then in 2008, we became a part of the Clorox family. So that helped us along, right? We realized how you know, living under the Clorox banner, the benefits of having, you know, the larger company and their resources. Then in 2014, we celebrated our 30th anniversary. And by then we had launched, you know, we had color and some cosmetics. We extended our skincare brand a lot of people don't know about. And we just continued to grow. And so now we're at this place where we have over 300 different products and across face, eyes, baby, pet. You know, you would be surprised to see all the things that are in Burt's.
Hey, everyone. Yeah, I'm Lakin. And diving a little deeper into what Crystal was just sharing is, I think it sometimes surprises people how many products we do have, because the classic lip balm, our beeswax lip balm, is probably the most widely known. But we do have, like Crystal was mentioning, many different types of products across a lot of different categories. So our core categories are lip care and associated lip products. So like our color color lip product, like our tinted lip balms. And then also our face care products are kind of what make up our core categories. And this is more than 60% of our total sales come from these core categories. Additionally to that, we have a lot of different types of products, a lot of baby products for baby and mama. We also have some men's products, some pet care products, acne specific products, toothpaste, the list kind of goes on and on. So as you take a look around our product portfolio, and I'll actually plug, we just relaunched our website with a brand new design a few days ago in January. So, take a look around burtsbees.com and see the category span of products that we have. And this is just an idea of what kind of products we work on, every day. All right, send it over to Mark for the BetterHelp VMS side.
Hello, I'm Mark Perry. And I want to start with giving you just a little background about the four brands that are under the umbrella of BetterHelp VMS. So back in the early 80s, actually in 1981, Rainbow Light was founded out in Santa Cruz, California. And then in 82, Natural Vitality was founded in Burbank, California. And then in the early to late 90s is when Renew Life came along. And that was founded actually in Florida. And then in 1998, our NeoCell brand was created. So those four brands were made way back when, and I think around 2016 is when Clorox started to acquire some of these brands. And that's when we became the umbrella of BetterHelp VMS in 2019. And so our mission pretty much is empowering families to be successful on their wellness journey. So we have a wide variety of different types of products, where we have calm gummies that you can see over my shoulder here, as well as we have tablets, capsules, powders, anything and everything to help you through your journey in terms of probiotics, in terms of vitamin C, and immune health, collagen, marine collagen, vegan collagen, and anything that you can imagine that can help you with your wellness journey. So we are truly looking forward to getting you introduced into the breadth of all of our products. And hopefully you've heard of some of our products or seen our products in stores. I know that the nutraceutical section can be overwhelming, but trust me, our products are top notch.
Thanks, Mark. And that just reminds me to take my vitamins too. So we'll do after this meeting. Awesome. So I just wanted to share a little bit how Mark and Lincoln and team, how everyone said they fit into the Clorox brand. So you might be thinking, okay, we have bleach and then we got vitamins and then we got lip balms. Like, how does that all fit together? Well, under the Clorox company, we do pride ourselves as being kind of like a health and wellness company. So our products are in 9 out of 10 households, which I'm sure many of our products are with you right now. So that's kind of how it all fits together. If you take a look at it this way, Burt's Bees and VMS are business units under the Clorox company that happen to work independently to create their own products. So just wanted to kind of give you a bigger picture about where this all fits in, because it is a little bit confusing, but wanted to share that. So with that, I'm going to actually transition. I'm going to stop sharing my screen, and I'm going to now include these panelists into just a quick little fireside chat so you can understand some of the roles that we're looking for and what a recruitment looks like. So as I transition, if you can all just type into the chat what your favorite Burt's Bees or vitamin, minerals, and supplements product is. If you can type that into chat, let me stop sharing my screen. And then we'll transition to the panel. Lip balm. Okay, we got a lot of lip balms. All right, perfect. Thanks so much for participating in that. Let's dive right into the panel. So I know that everyone kind of introduced themselves before their slide, but let's just dive into a little bit more of a introduction so you know exactly who you're talking to. So If I can have the panelists in this order, Lakin, Mark, Crystal, and Eddie, because that's who I see on my screen. If y'all can say your alma mater, how many years you've been at Clorox/Burt's Bees/VMS, your favorite Burt's or VMS product, and why? So we'll start with you, Lakin.
All right, so I'm Lakin Williams. I am a product development scientist with Burt's, and I'll go into a little bit more about what that is a little later on. But my alma mater, I have two. So my bachelor's degree is from the University of Southern Mississippi, and then my PhD is from Vanderbilt University. So I don't know if I saw any of those in the chat, but if you are here, welcome. I'm very happy to see you here. And then anchor down. I see that. Thanks. Go Commodores. My favorite product right now is actually a two punch. It's going to be the Mocha lip scrub followed by the overnight lip treatment. I'm really enjoying that at night as my part of my bedtime routine to really, scrub my lips, exfoliate them, and then to apply that really hydrating intensive lip treatment over them. Mark, I think you're next up.
Thank you. So I am Mark Perry. I am our senior scientist handling the packaging for our vitamins, minerals, and supplements division. I am a graduate of Michigan State University, go green. I've been with Clorox for 18 months now. And I've been doing packaging overall in general for about 16 years. My favorite product, I would have to say there's a few. And they're all gummies because our gummies are delicious. We have, and this is going to sound funny, but we have a kid's vitamin D that is a triple flavor, which is a mango, strawberry, and peach, which is, all three flavors are amazing. And as well as our Calm sleep gummies. So whenever I'm having a little bit of insomnia, I take those and I am good to go. So those are my two favorite VMS products.
Thanks, Mark. Don't worry, I take the kids' gummies too. Crystal?
You've been holding out on me, Mark, with the kids' gummies. We'll talk about that later. My name is Crystal Turner, and I am a senior scientist. I've been with Burt's for about 6 years, and I am in product development. And as Lakin said, we'll kind of discuss that a little bit more. My favorite is vitamin D3 gummies, because I'm terrible with that. And since Mark's given me, samples of the gummies, I've been really good. And our new, that's not out yet, my new product now is the shea butter. So look for that to be out soon. It's a shea butter body and hand cream.
Eddie Coles, nice to meet y'all. Went to Clemson University, so if there's any Tigers out there, go Tigers. I studied in packaging science at Clemson, started in Burt's with that, then transitioned to a process engineering role, and then now group manager within Burt's Bees. Been with Burt's Bees for coming up on 9 years now. Favorite product for Burt's Bees, I feel like I have to list a lip balm. Cucumber mint is my favorite lip balm, and then non-lip balm favorite product is the hydrating stick. It very much makes the face feel nice and refreshed. If after you've been on the move, moving and grooving, it's a nice refreshing feel.
Perfect. Thanks, team. I think we got a lot of ideas of what I need to buy next. It's still winter here, even in California, so awesome. So. Thanks for the introductions. We heard about a lot of products that our panelists has liked. Obviously, someone has to develop and package these products. And this is what specifically the R&D, which is the research and development team does. So Crystal, I'm going to kick this first question to you. In R&D, we talk a lot about the three Ps in terms of what we do in the department. Can you talk a little bit more about the three Ps and explain what they are working in R&D?
Yes. And so as you think of R&D, we think of it as a career destination, and we talk a lot about three Ps, and I'm gonna tell you two other ones that we don't talk about as much, but it's a continuation. So when we say product development, we're talking about people who design formulas. So they're doing more of the formulation development, creating the chemistry. and our process development, they're responsible for taking that chemistry from the bench and scaling it up, right? So that we can sell it into stores. And our packaging person designs the packages. They, you know, come up with sustainable options because we are Burt's, and they focus all around the packaging and the, you know, the optimization with the package and the product. But we also have two other categories. Eddie is one. He's an actual manager. So he started out in the technical space, but he's moved to be a people manager. So you can still do that in R&D, be a manager. And then we have a subject matter expert. So with years of experience and growth, you can become a subject matter expert at Burt's. Or R&D and Clorox at General. Let me take that back. That's just how we operate.
Thanks for explaining that, Crystal. So definitely there's a lot of different career paths within research and development team, whether you're on the VMS team or Burt's Bees team. And we're actually going to shoot this next question to both Lakin and Mark. So as a scientist, can you each tell us what you do in your respective business units? So give us a day-to-day glimpse into what is it that you do as a scientist. Lakin, I'll start with you.
Yeah, so as I mentioned, I'm a product development scientist. And so my main function in product development is actually formulation. So looking at formulation of lip balms, lotions, creams, cleansers, all of those products have to be formulated from raw materials. And one of the main focuses of Burt's Bees is natural raw materials. So we take things from nature and figure out how to use them for personal care products. So that's one of my main functions, is actually getting in the lab and working on those formulations and testing them. And then in conjunction with that, I work really closely with our marketing teams, our sales teams, our supply teams and production teams to actually bring that product formulation along into a fully formed product that you would see on the shelf. So working with all of the different scientists that Crystal mentioned, as well as all the other functions. So how do we market our product? I support our marketing team on that. How do we talk about the benefits in a clear way to our consumers, things like that. So that's my main area. And then, you know, we dabble in a lot of different things. So as there's other opportunities to learn, I'm always open, and there's always opportunities for folks to kind of get outside of their specific P and learn more.
Thanks, Lakin. And Mark, I know you're on one of the other P's, which you mentioned, packaging. Can you tell us a little bit more about your day-to-day?
Yes. So for the packaging role, like Lakin said, essentially we take the vision of marketing, sales, the consumer, and we're trying to make a sustainable package. So sustainability is huge for Clorox in general. And so with the packaging role, you're looking for the most sustainable option with the least amount of cost, as well as it meets the regulatory requirements. So all of our products require food grade plastics. And so making sure you understand the different polymers that are food grade, making sure you understand the fill requirements, and understanding that, you know, you want a nice shelf presence, as well as creativity, right? So in the packaging role, you kind of get a little bit of everything, where you're able to use your creativity, use your knowledge, and try to be as sustainable as possible while cost savings. You know, sometimes, you know, those things go hand in hand. You reduce plastic, you actually get a cost savings, right? And so during my days, you know, you write like specifications, making sure that you're meeting all the FDA regulations, as well as dealing with a cross-functional group. So you deal with quality, you deal with sales, you deal with marketing. So that's typically my day-to-day.
Okay. Thanks for sharing that. It sounds like both of you work in a lab, but at the same time, you also work cross-functionally with everyone else in the company to make sure everything gets done. It's not just a solo type of work, right?
No, you definitely are working as a team all the time. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Perfect. Definitely.
Yeah, awesome. All right. So speaking about working in teams, and you know, I love the description of what y'all do day to day. I always thought, you know, it would be really cool if I was a scientist, but that's just not my background. So I'm just a recruiter, but on a side note. But Eddie, this next question is for you. you know, working in Burt's Bees, especially being one of the people who've been here the longest, tell us something unique about working under the Burt's Bees brand.
Yeah, I think kind of touched on the first slide, but I don't know how many companies have a, the founder's house is outside of the headquarter building. So I think that's a little unique. I don't know how many also have a live beehive at their front door as well. So I think that just kind of gives you an idea before you walk into the building. I think one unique thing within the Burt's brand is how many different categories we touch. And Lakin kind of touched on it already as well as Crystal, but baby, mama, face, body, lip, cosmetics. We're in pet, or we're in baby clothing, candles. So we touch a lot. So one of the unique things is, you're able to work with a lot of different forms. You're able to work with a lot of different packages. So I think, there's a lot of different area that if you feel like you're getting bored with one thing, where the beauty is you're able to kind of mix it up with different forms, textures, packages, materials, you name it. So I also think the culture here and with VMS, vitamins, minerals, and supplements team also being under the same roof, the culture is, is unique, and it's something that I think kind of speaks to the link that folks have kind of been with the company and the culture within R&D. Obviously a little biased within an R&D standpoint, but I think we work hard. We got a lot going on, but I think we also like to celebrate and like to play hard when we're able to. So really like to celebrate team wins, company wins, whatever that may be. But I think Burt's is a pretty unique place, and I'll end with this. An exciting thing is if you're traveling and you're sitting on a train or you're sitting next to somebody on a plane and what do you do for work, yada yada, and you tell somebody you work for Burt's Bees, it almost seems inevitable. They light up and they tell you, oh, my favorite product is the cuticle cream, and let me show you this and that. And so it's exciting to see the excitement on consumers' faces when they light up telling about the product that you work on day in and day out. So I think that's kind of a unique thing about the Burt's Bees brand.
Yeah, and some of the same light that Eddie said, it's nice to actually see the products that you work on shelf. One of the things about VMS is it's an extremely fast-paced business that's consumer-driven and trendy. And so we consistently try to stay with the trends of the industry in terms of, what type of new active that we want to use, like ashwagandha, or a new strain of a probiotic or something like that. So we're extremely fast-paced, trying to make sure we stay faster than our competitors. The VMS space has about 200 competitors. And so, as you look at the nutraceutical, space, you see tons and tons of, products out there, but we always, try to, stay as quick as possible to get to the market. Another thing that makes us a little bit unique is you get to actually sample the products before they come to market, and they're usually delicious. So when we get the samples of all the flavors that we can potentially go for, it's nice. You get your daily vitamin intake, so you never have to purchase anything. You can always just, take what we have on stock, and we usually have samples all the time. Another thing with the VMS side is the creativity, like I said earlier, right? Like you're able to take, we can change our packaging up to be, so we can see the gummies, or, to have unique shapes and sizes. So there's just a lot of creativity and a lot of options out there that's for the, available for us to do. So.
All right. Thanks, Mark and Eddie. I think this is enough to convince me to almost move out to Durham and become a scientist. So if you guys are hiring, we'll see.
Come on out.
So speaking of hiring, I want to switch gears into the recruiting process, because yes, we are hiring. So hopefully this got you all a little bit interested in working for the either the VMS or Burt's brand. So let's switch gears in talking about the recruiting process. So Crystal, this first question is for you. In the recruiting process and in interviews, what are some of the transferable skills you see candidates bring from school to working as a co-op?
Okay, I would say critical thinking, and you hear that and you're like, oh, what do you mean? But being able to evaluate data or scenarios, solve problems, and communicate it in a way that everyone can understand, right? So, you know, thinking outside of the box is another one, your creativity, but that critical thinking, because that's a part of the way that you solve problems in some of your classrooms. So think of it that way, that systematic approach that you take to solve a problem. We do want that. Of course, we want people who have some laboratory experience. I want you to be able to know what a beaker is and weigh out information. You should at least have that. And if not, go on YouTube and look. Like, you should know something about the lab, right? When we talk about project management, we don't want you to necessarily be able to manage a project from beginning to end, but we want you to be able to independently work and get work done without having your hand being held all every step of the way. So think about the difference between being in high school and being in college, right? Your teacher is not going to be like, well, you know, this assignment needs to be it. That is how we're going to treat you at Burt. We're going to give you a job and we expect you to figure out a way to get it done. Now we're there to help you, but you should be able to work independently. And, effective communications, of course, right? Written and verbal. And last but not least, a collaborative spirit. Like Mark said, teamwork makes the dream work. And you're going to work with a team of people and they may be very different from you and you have to figure out a way to get work done.
Perfect. Thanks for sharing those tips, Crystal. So it seems like there's a lot of transferable skills even from school to work, whether you have previous internship experience, volunteering, you still have a lot of transferable skills from just what you learned in class. So that is perfect. Lakin, so taking those skills, how should a candidate approach an interview for the co-op recruiting process?
Yeah, the first thing that I would encourage everyone to do when you're looking to interview with any company, not just with Burt's Bees or Better Health VMS, but research that company to start with. Know a little bit about what they do, what they stand for. Burt's Bees specifically is a very values-driven company. So being able to speak to that and understand that you know what our values are and that you also are passionate and care about those same values is very important to us. And that's one of the first things that we will look for in an interview. In an R&D setting, technical curiosity is paramount. So that is another thing we're really trying to probe in an interview. So I'm asking a lot of questions so that I can understand, are you curious? Do you like to go into technical depth? Have you, sought things out on your own? That type of spirit is very, very important. And then a passion about your interests, what you care about, that always translates really well. You know, maybe it's not the specific thing that we're talking about that you're passionate about, but if you want to bring in how your passion might be kind of similar to the work you would do here, that's always really great. You don't necessarily have to have a passion for lotion. You can have a passion for a lot of things that brings, or even lip balm. You can have a passion for a lot of things that can tie into your work with Burt's Bees or VMS. And then I think the biggest thing or the last thing that I would be looking for is how you work with others. So being able to showcase how you're able to work in teams. You've heard it a lot here. We're very collaborative. We get along really well, but we can also be very professional and have those conversations. So if you can share how you've maybe handled conflict or how you have led teams, things like that are always really great for us to understand more about how you work in a group, because it is a lot of cross-functional work and you will have to interact with a lot of different personalities. And so that's really important.
All right. Thanks, Lakin. Speaking of the work, let's actually transition to co-op experience. So let's just say we passed the interview with flying colors. We got an offer. We're starting, let's just say in 2 weeks. Let's dive into what that experience even looks like. So Eddie and Mark, you both actually are managers of an intern or a co-op right now, and you have been as well. Eddie, I'll start with you first. What kind of projects does your current co-ops work on?
Yeah, so I'll talk. So we have our internships kind of separated two different ways. So we have our product development and process intern, and then we also have packaging. So from a product development and process, it's really going to be dependent on what's relevant and going on at that time. So I'll get to what those specific ones are, but the work that's provided is really relevant to what's going on with the project work at that time. that will lead to, you know, something that will be seen on shelf. So we have some preservative project work kind of going on with the interns, as well as we have a lip balm study that's looking more specifically into our lip balms, as well as we have pigment and glycerin interaction with some of our formulas that's also being looked at, as well as some water and oil emulsion. So kind of seeing a few different forms just alone, and that's just for the product development and process interns. From a packaging standpoint, we like to get them involved, not yet, but with a select customization. That's really our displays, more or less. So those also have shorter timelines. So really like to have that packaging intern be able to start and finish with that shorter timeline to be able to see that, work on it, and kind of point to something on the shelf, you know, after their time with Burt's Bees to say that that's something that they worked on. There's some pump work, checking different viscosities, some testing from that front, as well as just looking at different plastics and some discovery work from that, what may be some relevant sustainable information that could be relevant from a material standpoint in the future if we wanted to have a sustainable story.
Great. Sounds like it's never going to be boring. All right, Mark, how about you? What is your intern currently working on?
Yeah, so, you know, like Eddie said, it's current things that are happening within our business. So for us, some of the key things that I have my intern currently working on is like e-commerce testing. So e-commerce is a huge segment of our business. And so we've had some challenges with Amazon. So there's a lot of transit testing that's going on. So that's one project that my current intern is leading the charge with, as well as stability testing and just kind of understanding how temperatures affect our products. So that is another type of project that I have our interns working on as well. And then with our different types of products, we also have like filling challenges as well. So kind of understanding how our product settles over time with our powdered products and where that lands. Because, you know, with powders, they're different bulk densities in general. And so just based off of that, you know, making sure that we have the right amount of functional slack fill. So just a couple like interesting projects per se for packaging right now, and hopefully there'll be some more as things come along where, you know, there's more challenges that we need to have someone work on and have some critical thinking.
Well, sounds like you both are keeping your interns very busy and they have their hands full. So that's great that they're able to work on something that they may eventually get to see on shelves in the future. So love that hands-on experience. So speaking of that hands-on experience, you know, with the interns, Crystal, this question's for you. What are some R&D specific skills? So aside from knowing what a beaker is, what is some R&D specific skills that a co-op will need, but also like, what are they going to learn and gain from this experience from us?
Good question. And so I usually lead with, and you've heard Lakin say this term, is technical curiosity, right? And your tech, so that's technical knowledge. That's also, you know, what you know about the field. You may not know about lotions, but you know about chemistry, you know about math, right? So you can translate the skill set that you've learned in school or maybe a past to put that on your resume so that it makes sense of like you solved a problem, you created something, you learned something. So those are what we're looking at on your resume, as well as the work that you're going to do in the building. And that's something as a co-op that you could, you know, use as a part of your foundational learning as a chemist or engineer. So always think in those terms, right? Technical curiosity, number one. Effective communication, written and, you know, speaking. Be able to explain yourself and, you know, start with your objective and end with your next steps, you know, make a concise analysis and, you know, go with your hypothesis. It may be wrong, it's chemistry, hey, you know, but at least have a point of view. And then that whole enthusiasm, like you said, you may not love beauty because, you know, guys, when they come into color cosmetics, the first thing they think is like, I'm not wearing lipstick. But no, I am looking at viscosities. I'm understanding densities. I am looking at how you fill, the fill temperature. You know, so it's, we're still doing chemistry and engineering. And last but not least, you have to be creative, right? Be curious enough, creative enough to... We're looking for our co-ops to give us, you know, new information. So as well as you're trying us on, we're learning from you also, right? You're young, you're our demographic. We want to sell to people your age. So we want your ideas. So come with that willingness to be like, oh, I could change Burt's, right? What can I add to Burt's? You have a lot to offer.
Great. Hoping everyone's really hyped up right now and really passionate. Thanks for that, Crystal. I'm going to end with last question for Eddie. So Eddie, as an intern manager, what are some of your expectations of a co-op? Like, what makes one stand out during their internship?
So I think Crystal touched on some of those kind of in her previous answer. But I think, you know, the willingness to buy in. So, you know, one thing that VMS as well as Burt's Bees, it's relevant work that the intern is, which is one thing that I think is unique about both internships for the businesses, is that it's value added not only to the individual, but also to the business. So coming in, understanding that, you know, if we're not looking to provide busy work just for you to check off, you know, a co-op for your degree in curriculum, but it buying in that intellectual curiosity in the lab, problem solving is something that's just inherent within R&D. I think the one constant within R&D, that problems are going to come up. So it's okay. Identify the problem, figure out how you can look to go about the solution. And it might not be the first solution. It might be the 12th solution that actually solves the problem. So failure is going to happen. That's okay. But rebounding that continual curiosity of like and drive to look to figure out what can be and getting to that solution. A standout internship, I think, is buying in, not being scared to speak up. Crystal hit the nail on the head. Our target consumer is the age of college students these days, right? We're looking to understand. So speaking up and, you know, what do you think makes sense for a product? What would attract? What would deter? Where do you think is an area that could be bigger, could be bolder? Asking questions, you know, the one thing that I've heard Lakin, I don't work with Mark on a daily basis, but I've heard Lakin and Crystal mention with previous interns is the only way we're not able to help you with a question that you might have is if you don't ask that question, because we're not able to help and know what might be a potential problem. So ask the questions until you have cotton mouth and you can't speak anymore. But the more you can absorb and understand the business and with that buying in, I think it's an overall win in the sense that the individual is going to get the most out of the internship. The company is going to get the most out of it is truly buying in, getting to absorb that information and what drives you as a consumer. And we really like to use the internship as a launch ramp potentially for a full-time position as well. Now it's obviously pending if we have full-time position openings, but I was an intern myself back in the day. So I was fortunate enough to turn that into a full-time position. So, and we have several others within the R&D group. So truly I'd say just buying in to the work that you'll be during your time with Burt's Bees and BMS.
Thanks, Eddie. That was a great summary to our panel discussion. So thank you all for your feedback and insights into what y'all do and what goes into the recruiting process and what we're looking for at Burt's and BMS. So this is fantastic. I'm going to switch gears as we wrap up this panel to talk more about our open positions and how to apply now that hopefully we've gotten you all excited. So as I get ready to share my screen, if you all can type into the chat, what's something new you learned today, whether it's about Burt's, VMS, the recruiting process, what we look for an intern, what's something you knew you learned in this panel today? Let us know into the chat as I share my screen. The unseen nuances in roles like R&D. All right, this is awesome. I'm not gonna read everything out loud, but this is amazing. I'm glad you all picked up something within this session. So with that, I'm going to kick it back to Eddie, who will talk a little bit more about our Burt's Bees and VMS co-ops and how to apply for the positions.
Yep, so with the position, I think another thing that's very unique is you have two businesses that sit under the same roof. So even with our current co-ops today, you're able to be a part of dialogue and hear things within the vitamins, minerals, and supplements team that may not be talked on a day-to-day basis within Burt's Bees. And the unique thing is where we sit, it's a hodgepodge. So there's Burt's Bees folks sitting some places and they're sitting right next to Better Health BMS. So there's just that natural collaboration as well. And we even have folks kind of blurring the lines a little bit just with certain capabilities that some, you know, certain teams have that others don't. So I do think I'll just call out that as well as a unique ability just within the same, under the same roof. But with this, you're working with scientists and engineers. The beauty is you'll be able to work with, regardless of the P, you're going to be working with all three Ps. You'll be working with regulatory and cross-functionally as well, as Lakin kind of mentioned what all those different functions within the business units are. We have, I wouldn't say it's brand new, but it's pretty darn new from a wet lab standpoint. We've actually within for VMS and Burt's Bees, it's been about a year now. And then we have a packaging lab that Burt's and VMS share that's in the same building as well. That's a little older. I'd say it's about 2 years old now. So compared to the wet lab, it's ancient, I guess, but really unique with the lab space that we're able to have. For the interns, there's dedicated space and storage within the respective labs as well. So don't want you to think that you're working on top of somebody. There's dedicated space within the respective labs, whether that's the wet or the packaging lab. And again, kind of touched on this, but a variety of assignments you're going to be working on based on the current projects that you'll be assigned throughout your internship. Now, what those projects look like, I can't call that out because it's going to be relevant to what's going on at that time. So what it looks like in 6 months from now is going to be different than what's being worked on today. So, but working in the lab, visiting the facility, one unique thing about Burt's Bees is we do have our manufacturing site about 15 minutes away. So being able to do a tour, we do look to include VMS interns on that as well, just to be able to tour a manufacturing site that's a little closer that you're able to hop into a car from that standpoint. And then, you know, kind of touched on, you know, skills and expertise. Crystal mentioned, you know, subject matter experts within Burt's Bees. We have several subject matter experts and VMS does as well, but able to pick the brain. One thing within the co-op is during the first week, kind of, I almost feel like an overload, but just flood the interns with folks that I'd like to get them to have one-on-ones to just meet, introduce, absorb all that they may be doing and what their expertise may be in as well. So setting up those meetings is really something that we look to pride on, and then, you know, get you involved with trainings and then get you set up for anything that may be of interest to you if there's something of a project that comes up during your time also with Burt's Bees. And then kind of how you can, if we haven't scared you off yet, how you can look to apply for either of the positions is you can either scan the QR code, which you'll see on the right hand of the screen, or you can look to follow that link, the CloroxCompany.com/careers, follow that to the open positions, and you should be able to apply to the co-ops. You are able, it is different. I also, you know, you'll see a Burt's packaging co-op as well as a VMS packaging co-op. You're welcome to apply to both of those if you're looking specifically from a packaging standpoint. And then from a R&D product process co-op, don't let it deter you by just seeing cosmetic chemistry or chemical engineer. If you have a different background, that's okay. Feel free to still apply if you're interested. But either scanning the code or going through the website will be the best ways to apply for the positions.
Thanks, Eddie. And I do want to note for this session, specifically for our webinar, we are here promoting our positions within the research and development, can't say that today, the R&D function under the 3Ps. So again, product, process, and packaging. As y'all know, as some of you may have joined because you saw Burt's Bees or VMS within this webinar, we do have other positions within Burt's Bees and VMS. So again, check out this QR code or our website for our open positions. But today we are here specifically to promote our science-based positions. So just an FYI on that, if this is not only what we hire in, you heard everyone, we hire for more than just R&D, we hire in finance, marketing, et cetera as well. But just know that today's session, that's what it was focused on, which is why the panel was focused on that.
And I will just add, yep. Deadline is this Sunday coming up, if you are interested. So please look to apply no later than Sunday, February 5th.
And we promise it's a very simple application. You just load in your resume, fill out a couple of things, like that's pretty much it. So we promise it's not gonna take you a while. All right, so at this time we have concluded our intro, our panel. Now you know where to apply. I'll go ahead and send out an email to everyone after this call as well. So I'm gonna stop sharing. And I know we had quite a few questions in the chat, which I know Lakin was kind of trying to tackle.
I am so furiously trying to type over here, but if I didn't get to your question, I apologize. And Stella, are we going to open it up to questions now? Okay.
I'm kind of going to bundle some of the questions together. So I see quite a few questions about, do we have any internships open for other types of engineering like computer science? I'm going to take a small section to say, yes, we do. Actually, we have another session on February 15th. Which you can sign up for. It's through our IT group, and you'll get to hear more about that group in the similar format. So if you're interested in computer science or other engineering-based roles, please log on to Way Up and fill and find the webinar for February 15th. I will be back next week with that group. So just wanted to address that. This is a really good question. And I think either VMS or Burt can answer, but you mentioned family wellness as a strong emphasis on the consumer. And how do you see this reflected in the Burt's Bees employee environment? That's a really good question. So going a little bit into culture there.
I'm happy to take this one because I also serve as one of the Burt's Bees and the Hill Building, which is our location well-being champion. So I kind of act as a liaison and ambassador for all of our benefits programs to the broader organization and mostly just to my smaller team and location. So there are a ton of wellness programs and benefits that Clorox and Burt's Bees offer that allow you to take advantage of different services that are available. So we have employee assistance programs for mental health benefits. We obviously have benefits for, you know, health and dental. We have a great 401k program for financial wellness. So there is a lot of different opportunities with those benefits. And then even just at the, you know, smaller, kind of like closer to your management side, all of our managers are very open to working with people for different schedules that they may need. So we're open on flexibility for scheduling, different times to be in the office. We have different opportunities or spaces in the office to go and maybe get away for a moment, have a quiet moment to yourself if you need that. There's places to relax with others. So there's a ton of different ways that I think Clorox as a whole supports yourself and your wellness, and then also with your family, allowing you to have that flexibility, and then also a lot of those benefits that can support your family as well. And Crystal, Eddie, Mark, if you have any other things to add, I am always, please add them, because I am such a big advocate for our benefits programs and everything we do to support people.
Oh yeah, I'd like to add one that we recently had a wellness expo at the Hill Building where we had some yoga sessions going, workout sessions, massage sessions. We had all our products displayed, so everyone was able to sample all of our different incoming unreleased products before they hit the market. So we had some nice calm powders, some brain gummies for memory, things of that nature, some turmeric gummies, which was good for joints and inflammation. So a lot of things that were, before they were released, the entire building was able to partake in, and it was awesome. It was a good like day to just unwind, get a massage, exercise, try some products. And they also promote was it wellness days, where you actually will take a day just for your well-being, right? As well as we're doing this thing now called recharge weeks to let you just recharge, relax, mandatory time off, as well as quiet days. So there's occasionally once a month, there's a day, a Monday, where no meetings, no chats, just it's a day for you to just take care, put your head down and get your work done. So some of the other things that we do to make sure that you're mentally stable while you're at Clorox.
And I think the list goes on.
I just want to add one thing about our campus. So Eddie mentioned about the house being out there and the beehive, but we sit on a, we our building is an old tobacco warehouse. So imagine wood floors and lighting and just kind of old school look vibe, but it's just a laid back kind of culture in the sense that we get work done. But I mean, I literally will take a, you know, a walk around the campus, which is around our baseball stadium, like every day to just kind of relax myself. So it's a very different vibe. I've been in this industry for about 30 years, but it's more of a, like we get work done, but it's more of a culture of like, you know, we're allowing you to be creative and get your work done and not a stuffy environment. We literally have a gym upstairs, right? Up a shower and a mirror, and you know, we got it's literally meant, we have kombucha on tap at our job. Like, who has that? So it's that type of culture. So it's pretty nice.
And our gym has a Peloton and a Tonal.
All right, we're there. Thanks for sharing all that. I think something that people don't realize, like I mentioned in the beginning, we do consider ourselves a health and wellness company. So I think it's important to offer a lot of the resources like Crystal and Mark talked about. So I know we have just a couple minutes left. I wanted to get a couple answers to this one particular question because I think it's pretty interesting. So the last question I will ask the panelists, someone would love to know about the sustainable agricultural practices that Burt's or VMS is following. So like Mark, you talked a lot about sustainability for your packaging, obviously Burt's is as well. Can you each talk about some of your sustainability practices?
Yeah, I can start. So we include a lot of post-consumer resin into our products. So a few of our bottles, if not mostly 80% contain post-consumer resin. So that's taking virgin plastic out of the system. We also did a project where we were reducing our plastic gram weights by 35%. So that's also reducing our carbon footprint in the world. So we're also trying to make sure we follow the how to recycle guidelines. So there's a website you go to where you list your components, and you want to make sure that you're like visibly showing the consumer, how do you recycle this? So, you know, removing the liner or removing X film or whatever and making sure that it's going in the right recycle streams. So we try to do our part in making sure that, you know, we use less corrugated or we use 100% corrugated materials and things of that nature. So we follow the same sustainable guidelines or principles that like the Burt's folks will talk about as well.
Yeah, and from a Burt side, from a formulation standpoint, we have a natural standard or natural origins that we look to obtain to for all of our formulas. So raw materials are we're looking to be sustainably sourced. So look to have stories not only with our raw materials, we'll look to have second sourcing from a sustainable aspect as well there. We'll look to keep formulas simple where possible to also help reduce from that sustainable formula where you don't have an ingredient list that takes up the entire back label of a product. From a packaging standpoint, we'll also work with post-consumer recycled materials. We will also look at widely recycled materials, and if they're not widely recyclable, we'll look to use TerraCycle as a recycling method for all of our packaging as well. So we look to use bioresins as well. So to Mark's point, where can we look to reduce virgin plastic within our packaging is another aspect from that. And this is going to be separate from the question But I did see the question asked, which I think is a good one, and I apologize I did not address. The internship for both VMS and Burt's are looked to be on site in Durham. So they would not be fully remote. You could look to work from home at times, so there is a hybrid aspect to it, but looking to be in the office majority of the time to get those hands-on experience. So do just want to call that out, so there's hopefully no questions in regards to, but do look for the interns to be on-site in Durham.
And we do offer a housing and transportation stipend, so you're not on your own. Just wanted to put that in there too, as we do require you to relocate to Durham, right? Perfect. So we have a million other questions. Really great session. I want to thank everyone on the call who's still left for joining us and sticking with us today. I'm glad you all learned so much and are enthusiastic about our brand. Again, please make sure you apply by our deadline this Sunday if you're interested in our co-op positions, and connect with us on LinkedIn as well. But otherwise, we enjoy sharing this information with you, and we hope you all have a great rest of your day and hope to see you in one of our offices in the future. Thank you.